Welcome, everybody, and thanks so much for coming. And we're now going to do the opening invocation or meditation where we just open our hearts and we just have this wonderful opportunity to send love and gratitude to our world and for our lives. So let's do that.
Let's take some slow, deep breaths to get into that peaceful, receptive state. So we breathe in slowly and deeply. We hold our breath. We breathe out. And then we hold our breath. Let's do that for a few more breaths.
Excuse me, I've just had a message from Antoinette to say she can't, there's no sound. Can anybody not hear me?
We have sound.
It's faint.
Well, only on the meditation, but we have sound. You're coming through clear.
You can hear the meditation.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So, Ant, anyway, I hope it worked. Okay. We'll carry.
Now let's listen for our heartbeat. Our heartbeat, which is a pulse of light coming down through the silver cord from our mighty iron presence, anchoring in our heart, giving us life. Let's just see and feel and bless that heartbeat. That heartbeat that anchors into that beautiful threefold flame, which is the anchorage of our mighty I Am presence within our physical bodies. Let's just connect with that beautiful flame as we sit in that expanded golden flame in the center, golden yellow flame of wisdom and illumination, perception and discrimination. We see our bodies in this beautiful, dazzling golden flame. To the right, we can see the pink flame, that glorious, dazzling pink flame of pure divine love. And then we see to the left of us that beautiful expanded flame, that sapphire blue, bringing into us the feeling of the will, the power, the faith, and the protection from our mighty I Am presence. See and feel and bless this glorious light. Let's take our awareness now up through the top of our head, through the silver cord, to our mighty, beloved I Am presence. Let's see this glorious, all-powerful, all-knowing, all-loving presence smiling down on us. Our wonderful presence of God, I Am. And now we see in the center of our chest a beautiful golden sun forming, dazzling and brilliant like the noonday sun, the beautiful focus of light from our I Am presence. Open our hearts and send love and gratitude to our mighty I Am presence for beating our heart and giving us life. And now we see those rays from our beautiful sun in the center of our chest, dazzling and brilliant, billions and billions of rays going forth and connecting up with each and every miniature sun in all the cells of our bodies, our four earthly bodies, all those little inner workers receiving this expanded light. Let's feel the joy, the happiness, and the gratitude of each and every little inner worker of our four earthly bodies. Sense and see and feel that wonderful light saturating our earthly bodies. And now let's just fill our feelings with a feeling of love and gratitude. And let's call to the beloved Ascended Masters, beloved Ascended Master David Lloyd, the great God of gratitude, to fill us, each one and all mankind, with this feeling, that light substance from the Ascended Master realm of gratitude and love. We see our beautiful suns turning a deep shade of pink with a golden radiance. Gratitude and love for all our many, many blessings. Gratitude and love to the great Ascended Hosts for these marvelous teachings. Gratitude and love for all our loved ones and our friends. Gratitude and love for our homes and our supply. Gratitude and love for all the many, many blessings that we receive daily on our earthly journeys. Gratitude to the great and beloved elemental kingdom, animate and so-called inanimate, the beauty and bounty of nature. God bless, love and thank them, each and every precious one. Gratitude to the beloved angels, and gratitude to all life on our beloved earth. And now we see these rays in this wonderful expanded state, forming a lattice of light, dazzling and brilliant. We see our entire earth folded in this glorious pink and golden light, saturating every part of life on our beloved earth, especially those parts of life that are never loved or thanked, with this wonderful gift, our opportunity of sending love, light, and gratitude to all life. And we just give deep, deep thanks for this.
Ah, lovely. All right, so now, beloved Jonathan has said he will read the opening invocation for us. Thank you, beloved Jay.
Thank you. Before reading the words of the Master, we say together with mics muted, as suggested by beloved Lord Kathumi. Beloved Presence of God, I am. It is thy life and intelligence that enables me to read and comprehend and absorb that which is required of me. For life, I am so grateful. Beloved Master Kathumi, I ask for your feeling and your capacity to use this instruction for God's glory and mankind's comfort. We thank you. And now, great I Am Presence, take me within thyself. There instruct me and cause me to retain the full memory of these inner instructions. Thank you. From beloved Saint Germain.
Marvelous. Thank you so much, beloved Jay. All right. So we've got today, it's the final part of chapter 8, God's Omnipresent Power. And it's the wonderful part. It's the completion of the story of Guy Ballard and David Lloyd's ascension. Really, just really a wonderful, wonderful part. So we're blessed with that. And then I did make a... We recorded it between myself and John. We managed to record the peace invocation that beloved Antoinette does for us every morning. It's such a powerhouse. Anyway, so I thought it would be actually lovely for us to actually listen to this today, because it's on, I put it on a YouTube, video and just open our hearts and send peace to the beloved world. It's just such a wonderful opportunity. And it ties in actually with a song we're going to listen to, which is from Sinead O'Connor. God bless her. She transitioned to the higher realms. And I just found a beautiful song that she sang. The Lord, make me an instrument of your peace was such a beautiful one. So I just thought that would tie in nicely. And then, beloved, Terry's going to read the five-pointed star, which actually is from, it's about Sanat Kumara and the coming of the 30 Kumaras. Oh, it's just such a heart-opening piece from beloved El Morya. And as we know, El Morya can open our hearts like none other, I find. It's just quite extraordinary. And then we've got beautiful harmony required for our complete service. And the retreat of Great God Lomaray is actually over Madagascar. So it's lovely to feel the closeness while we're here in Africa, where there is a lot of peace needed. But I know there's a lot of harmony and peace needed all over the world. Then I'm going to read from beloved Hercules, that mighty and beloved one, just so marvelous. And then beloved Antoinette will take us through our really important part of the whole service, which is saying the decrees, calling in the light. So we're going to listen now to Gerald Craig reading this final part.
After a most wonderful voyage, we arrived at Southampton, went on to London, and presented my credentials to the Bank of England. The official to whom I presented them remarked, "Yes, we were expecting you today. Here are your bank and checkbooks." I looked at them to see how much my fortune amounted to, and was amazed to learn £100,000 had been placed to my credit. 5 years later, my mother passed on. I transferred one half of my wealth to a bank in New York and began the search for the man with the crystal cup. I can never repeat the disappointments, the trials, the sorrow I have been through, but in the face of everything, somehow I could never give up. The thing which seems so strange to me is, while I have grown old in outer appearance, my energy and strength are as great as ever. Sometimes I think greater than in my fullest youth. In years, I am 70. Today, I just wanted to follow this trail, and praise God, I have found you. My desire was so great, it was almost irresistible. But, my good man, I asked, what am I to do for you? You will know, he replied, for I know I have made no mistake. In the heart of this majestic mountain is a great power. I feel it. Ask God to show you what to do. Suddenly, I felt the mighty God power surging forth so strong, it almost lifted me from the ground. Making the sign Saint Germain had taught me, I called to God for light, and raising my hand in salutation said, "Mighty God, in man and the universe, we seek thy light. We seek thy wisdom. We seek thy power. Let thy will be done in and for this my brother, who has sought and found me to do for him I know not what. Thou knowest. Manifest thy will through my mind and body, and let whatever is to be done for this brother, thy son, come forth." As my hand came down, it held the crystal cup, filled with living liquid light. I offered it to him, and my mighty God self spoke again. "Drink without fear. Thy search is ended." He drank the contents without a moment's hesitation. I stepped forward quickly and took both his hands in mine. Slowly and steadily, every vestige of age disappeared from him, and the God in me continued, "Behold, thou art forever free from all earthly limitation. Ascend now unto the great host of light who await thee." Very slowly he began to rise from the ground, and as he did so, his human garments disappeared and he became clothed in raiment of glistening white. I let go his hands, Then, in a voice of deepest love, he said, I shall return to thee, beloved brother. Well shalt thou be repaid for this transcendent service. Thou wert the only one through whom this could be done for me. Some day thou shalt see why. And with a happy smile, he disappeared on a radiant pathway of light. As the mighty God power within me receded, I was so astounded. I fell on my knees and offered the deepest prayer of my life in grateful humility and praise for the privilege of giving such service. I rose, and the Master Saint Germain received me into his wondrous embrace. My beloved brother, he said, I am greatly pleased. Noble and faithful was your attendance upon the great God within you. Beautifully did you receive your mighty God in action. I do indeed congratulate you. You will ever be held within our embrace, even though outwardly you may not always be aware of it. You have become a worthy messenger of the great white brotherhood and the ascended host. Hold close to your mighty God self. Thus, you will ever be ready for service wherever and for whatever is required. My love enfolds you until we meet again. I will keep you informed. Slowly, I wended my way back to the lodge, every step praise and gratitude to the one mighty God that molds us all into eternal perfection.
Wow, absolutely marvelous. Okay, I just had a message from Aunt, and unfortunately her phone managed to get in contact with some water. Oh, just saying, all these initiations we get to keep the peace no matter what. Anyway, so we'll just see how it goes. And in the meantime, we've got her anyway. So that is a blessing. How divinely planned is that? Saying this wonderful peace invocation for us. So let's just open our hearts and really send out that peace from our mighty I Am presence to just bless all life, especially those parts of life that are in need of peace. And we just, we give thanks for this.
And now, before we send our peace into the world, let's just call on all the mighty beings that minister to the ruby and golden flame of peace. That flame of peace, ministration, and grace. We call to you, beloved Master Jesus, the Prince of Peace, and to beloved Lady Nada. We call to John the Beloved, great Archangel Uriel and Donna Grace, the mighty Archangels of Peace. And we call in the legions of angels ministering to this flame of peace. We call to beloved Tranquility and mighty Pacifica, the great Elohims of Peace. To beloved Geneva, to beloved Darius from Sirius and Lord Himalaya, to Lord Siraya and Lord Cusco from the Temple of Peace. We call to the beloved God of Harmony and invoke the mighty spirit of this flame of peace. And we ask that we can direct it like a ruby and golden river of light into the four earthly bodies of all mankind, enfolding each and every one of us, every man, woman, and child, in a pillar of peace. Peace, harmony, comfort, and tranquility. We ask that we can direct this flame into every home, every family, every community, every workplace, every town, every city, every country, every nation. Beloved flame of peace, go forth and do your perfect work. Flood our earth with your mighty light. Charge this feeling of ascended master peace into every human heart. Charge this flame through the entire nature kingdom into all distressed or distorted elemental forms. Let Let a great and mighty peace flood the entire nature kingdom. We take this opportunity now to call to the great cosmic angel Mecca, that glorious angel of unity, and we ask that you enfold each and every one of us in your golden liquid light. The golden light of the Christ. That we can direct this light out of our hearts into the golden grid surrounding our entire earth. Into the crystalline grid surrounding our earth, expanding and amplifying that feeling of peace, unity, and love. Let our great and mighty peace descend upon the face of the earth. Peace descend, peace descend, peace descend, descend, descend. Peace defend, peace defend, peace defend, defend, defend. Peace command. Peace command, peace command, command, command. Peace I am, peace I am, peace I am, I am, I am. And as we place our attention on this beautiful thought form, the pure white dove of peace, we just feel ourselves completely enfolded in an infinite supply of heavenly peace. We see our entire earth completely enfolded in that mantle of cosmic Christ peace. And we call to you, beloved Donna Grace, and we ask that you fill us with your sustained feeling of listening grace, ever present, conscious, and aware in every moment of that still small voice, the divine guidance of our beloved I Am presence. And we ask that all our songs, all our decrees, all our joyful, loving service be protected and enfolded in this ray of peace, that they can manifest instantly to bring freedom, victory, healing, joy, happiness, abundance, liberty, and eternal peace to our beloved earth and all who are so blessed as to live upon her. We thank you, thank you, thank you for this gift of peace. Thank you.
Oh, lovely, beloved aunt. Every morning we send that peace out. It's such a blessing to be able to do it, and just bless beloved Antoinette. She always does it with the same wonderful enthusiasm. Right, now we're going to have beloved Terry. Thank you, beloved Terry. Do you know what? I forgot to record. Oh, my gosh. And I haven't.
No, it's recording. No, it's recording.
I suddenly thought I forgot to record. Oh, thank goodness. Well done. Okay. thank you. Okay. Whoopsie daisy. Now, where is it now? I thought I'd got it going. Share. Oh, I think it. There we go. Can you see it, Terry?
Yes, I sure can.
Okay. Marvelous. Thank you so much, beloved.
Thank you. Greetings, everyone. The building of Shamballa from beloved El Morya. The five-pointed star signifies the leaving of beloved Venus and the coming to the earth of the Kumaras. In Eastern Asia, there stretches a great desert today over the land used by the Venusian brothers as the habitat of their cosmic lord. It is now known as the Gobi Desert and was at that time a beautiful island sea, in the center of which lay a lovely green and shining island, which they called the White Island, and which was to be the site for the building of the ageless Shamballa, the home of celestial love. The 30 volunteers from Venus who had tied their soul's light into the wheel of Earth's evolution.
Participants in the meeting. This meeting is being recorded.
Somebody needs to mute. The 30 volunteers from Venus who had tied their soul's light into the wheel of Earth's evolution began the great task of building on the White Island a temple of light to be the home of Sanat Kumara and his lieutenants. Laboring for over 900 years, passing from the outworn earthly bodies, but to return without the spiritual respite of a heavenly rest. They completed the old domed temples, the perfection of the white city that was to be the marvel of the earth for centuries to come. How can mere words clothe the constancy of this service in a form that can convey the fidelity of those 30 beings of flame? Finally, all was in readiness. The hour of Earth's initiation was come. The Karmic Lords had bowed before the august presence of Sanat Kumara and his three lieutenants and awaited, in love, their visitation. Nature and man's elect were ready. The stars and suns of the system, for a moment, were stilled, and the supreme sacrifice in silence was effected. Out from the aura of Venus, the first great rosy glow of the expanding aura of the Kumaras began to suffuse the sky with the glory of a celestial dawn. Then upward soared a great five-pointed star until it stood suspended above the planet Venus, intensifying the aureole of colors. All the souls of Venus knew that any cosmic activity of the great Kumaras was presaged by the presence of the star, which appeared to herald announcements or decrees of the Lords of the Flame, which would affect the progress of the great Venusian state. Every heart on Venus was focused on that star, waiting its message of the hour. Slowly and majestically, there rose into the rays of the star four shining golden figures that stood for a moment, pouring out their blessing and their heart's deepest love to the planet of their birth. Little did their children know the deep feeling in the hearts of the Kumaras as they bade their star goodbye, not for a lifetime, but for uncertain centuries yet unborn from the womb of time. And then there rose a burst of sound, and the people of Venus, for the first time in the history of the planet, saw the star begin to move outward toward the periphery of their sphere. Within it, moving slowly and majestically, were the figures of the solar lords. All fell on their knees, and a beautiful hymn of blessing and love rose from the inhabitants of Venus, tinged with the great sadness of parting, enfolding the departing figures in a mantle of most sacred love. Thus the four Kumaras left the light of Venus for the shadow of the earth's aura. Of the seven Kumaras, four sacrificed themselves for the sins of the world and the instruction of the ignorant to remain till the end of the present Manvantara. Oh, how different the reception was from the parting. The earth was spinning darkly on her bended axis. No hearts were upraised. There was no song of welcome gratitude. Ah, yes, 30 small pinpoints of light, like faint flickering candles, guided the cosmic master's descent. And slowly and majestically, the great pink aura blanketed the earth. What was the sudden comfort and hope and peace that entered into the hearts of men? What caused the withered flowers to raise their heads, the birds to sing with new sweetness, the children to laugh again? What was this mysterious, unseen ether that entered into the very atmosphere of earth? Only 30 waiting spirits knew. And as they knelt in reverent love before the smiling presence of their longed-for Lord, ah, Sanat Kumara, Lord of Love, one day shall we return you and your shining band to your own beloved star. And as you go, the shining light of earth will be a mighty crest that carries you triumphant, leaving us a star of freedom, accepted by the cosmic law as a permanent focus of blessing in our system through your love. Beautiful. Beloved La More, great god of harmony, speaks from the Temple of Harmony, Madagascar. my quality required to complete your service. My love pours to you, dear ones, and since my quality is the one required for you to complete your service, then allow me to charge you with all the harmony which divine law will permit. I want you to take this harmony and expand it to unfold the entire planet so that all mankind may be privileged to feel and experience this same wondrous ecstasy and joyfulness which you, beloved ones, accept into your daily lives. I am happy to say there is certain instruction which I have been permitted to release to you. It, of course, concerns your divine service and also how that service may be fulfilled without the slightest obstacle. And of course, this concerns the human. My beloved ones, do you realize that the human is as sensitive on its own level as the Holy Christ Self is on its level? And whenever there is any outer vibration occurring in your thoughts and feelings, which might in any way make you want to drop out of this great activity, there is only one thing to do. Ignore it. Do you realize that the only thing the human is sensitive to anything vibrating on or below its own level, the only time you may depend on it to guide you in the proper direction is when it is holy and free of all human qualities. I want you to remember that you are not expected because of society or any other outer activity to accept anything into your world which is human. Take your stand and assert your dominion. The outer consciousness itself is pure and holy, composed of life energy, the same life energy that pours directly to your own I Am presence, your holy Christ self, and the flame within your heart. And then it goes from you in the way you desire to direct and qualify it. There is nothing imperfect at all about the outer consciousness, except that which you allow to be imposed upon it to unbalance your thought, feeling, and action. The solution for balancing the human does not lie in raising your thoughts, feelings, or actions, but rather in raising your point of attention. This is the solution, beloved ones, to raise your consciousness above all imperfect thought, feeling, and action directly to your own God presence. How else can your ascension be made unless you raise everything? Even your body is eventually absorbed into the great central sun to be purified and sent forth again. So, beloved ones, you can save yourself a great deal of time and unnecessary effort and take advantage of the flame within your heart and use it as a great central sun to purify and balance everything within your being and definitely see that your outer consciousness vibrates in accordance with your holy Christ self on its own level. All the light from Madagascar pours to you, as well as the light and blessings of every ascended master and every ascended master focus, retreat, and etheric city within the atmosphere of this planet. I, La More, thank you with all my love, enfold you, and with all the harmony I am permitted to release, I shall hold this group together with or without the assistance of the human eternally, and that harmony is eternally sustained. God bless you.
And how marvelous is that? Thank you so much, beloved Tyrion. Oh, yeah, just bless them both, those mighty beloved beings. Just be just so blessed with these ascended masters and how they help us. All right, so now, before we listen to the animal video, we've got a sweet one today. We're going to read from the gems. This is very, very interesting, I thought. And it comes from Archangel Uriel, from the Law of Life and Teachings by Divine Beings, which was compiled by Eddie K. Look. And freedom comes when we are masters of circumstances by the flame within our hearts. And I know that, you know, we do have this told to us again and again, but this really explains, I believe, why they actually withhold. And I think there's somewhere else in that book where I read a similar thing. They literally withhold things so that we actually like learn to precipitate. Because as we know, we've been focusing on that a couple of weeks before this time now. And this is what the beloved Archangel Uriel says. You have applied to become masters of the power of the sacred fire, masters of thought, feeling, and circumstance at inner levels before the cosmic board and before your own Christ self. You have, therefore, forsworn faith healings until you have developed the capacity within your own consciousness to recreate perfection at will. This is a very important and subtle point. You have asked in regard to healing and in regard to finance that you might become master, conscious master of the power of precipitation and conscious master over your bodies, minds, and worlds, so that the scientific understanding of the law which you would receive would make you able to assist hundreds and thousands by like change of consciousness, which would bring a change of effect in the world of form. You are endeavoring nightly while out of the body and daily in your own thinking and feeling selves to learn the key by which the combinations of energy and application will result in a perfect manifestation. You do not wish to have any manifestations handed to you by an external source, lest the inner cause again be set up and you find yourself again in chains. Well, there we have it. So, you know, that's a very important thing for us to stand. And I find it so comforting that because sometimes I wonder, you know, but as we know, we need to practice that precipitation, practice healing our own bodies, because that is really mastery, isn't it? So that's what they're telling us there. So marvelous. Now we're going to say this wonderful decree for our beloved brothers and sisters that have left their physical bodies and are in the psychic and astral realms. So we say together with the full wonderful feeling, we say, beloved presence of God, I am in me, beloved immortal threefold flame of eternal truth within my heart, and beloved Saint Germain. While my body sleeps this night, let all the constructive energy of my entire life stream, including that in my causal body, be used to render whatever service is needed in the violet flame temples established in the psychic and astral realms to draw the full gathered cosmic momentum of the violet purifying flame of divine love and compassion through every discarnate life stream there. Let all the souls who dwell in those realms be drawn into those purifying temples of mercy and compassion, and there have the accumulated destructively qualified energies of their life streams purified and transmuted, so that when they are summoned for re-embodiment by the lords of karma, they bring into incarnation only a heritage of perfection, and carry in their life streams no miscreations that would add to their own or the world's distress. We accept this done now with full cosmic power, and so be it, beloved I am. And we just thank you for this, and we thank you for this opportunity to make this wonderful call for our brothers and sisters. Okay, so now we're going to listen to this, watch this marvelous video. It's just the friendship between various, you know, interspecies, different species of the animal kingdom. It's just absolutely charming. I hope you enjoy it as much as I did.
People say that one and one make two, but there's something greater when it's me and you. When you're weary, I will share the load, 'cause we are travelers on the same road. Oh, how this crazy world can spin, so glad that I can count you in. Gonna stick around. There's no mountain that's too high to climb. We'll help each other up and we'll be fine. Oh, how this crazy world goes by. So glad that you are by my side.
So lovely. I love the captain of mouse, great friends. It's just too precious. And now we're going to say this wonderful decree for our beloved animals, because we also think of the insects, the reptiles, when we say this decree. So we just say together, beloved, I am presence of all mankind. Charge your mighty light of mercy and compassion to flow through us all and bring comfort to the animal kingdom. May each human being remember and accept their responsibility as guardians and protectors of this planet's pure and innocent life until all is set free and their divine plans fulfilled. We so decree it and so be it. In God's most holy name, I am. We accept it done and we thank you. Thank you, thank you. Right, so I'm going to read now. I want to see if Ant's back on. Doesn't look like it. Okay, so I might have to do her decree, she said, for her. Bless beloved Ant. Oh my gosh, we get tested with these initiations that come to keep the peace. I know all those so well, that feeling. Goodness me. Anyway, so I'm just going to change the share. And we're going to read from Mighty Hercules. And as we know, he's the divine complement of Holy Amazon. And the activities, they are part of the great elemental kingdom of the great Elohim and Eloha, the builders of our beautiful earth. And their activities are strength, power, and protection. And he says to us, beloved staunch spirits of the Almighty serving upon the planet Earth with the one purpose in mind, that of doing the will of God and assisting the spiritual hierarchy in bringing the permanent golden age to fruition as quickly as possible, I greet you with the deep gratitude of my being. The limitless field of cosmic service open to any individual who has a conscious knowledge of the use of the sacred fire can scarcely be conceived by the intellect of man. Every individual, finding himself restricted by a physical garment, experiencing the limitations which the imposed karma through the misuse of God's energy has placed upon that vehicle. However, once the consciousness is freed from the limiting concepts of human thinking, that one may soar on the wings of life, light, into the cosmic consciousness and become a conscious dweller in the fourth dimensional plane. Such a one then has the power to adjust conditions of an imperfect nature which are expressing in the world of form. A moment's reflection will show the chela that he is of the same mind as the cosmic or ascended being, for in the oneness of that consciousness, he becomes immersed in the ecstasy and beauty of perfection, and his being pulsates with the desire to bring perfection to all life. At this point, I would like to impress upon your consciousness that perfection is everywhere. And while you, in using the limited consciousness of the human self, sometimes feel that you are limited in your service, you should endeavor at all times to dismiss such an idea. When one thinks of limitation, he is thinking of the lower self, forgetting that he functions at all times from consciousness. Limitation only occurs when he chooses the human rather than the cosmic consciousness of perfection. We have recently brought to your attention the ease with which you may cross the bridge from the human into the realm of the divine, and contemplation will show you that the rationality of choosing the cosmic consciousness. When a chela functions from the cosmic consciousness, he has the ability to draw the sacred fire from the one supreme source of which he is an active component, and may direct the rays of light to treat any negative manifestation through the merciful use of the seven rays. Should the requirement be one of healing, purity, divine love, illumination, and so on. We have counseled you to become co-creators with the spiritual hierarchy, and the hour has now arrived when you should be able to function freely from the higher consciousness. If you would make it a practice of consciously returning to the consciousness when, due to a momentum gained through the centuries of functioning in the lower consciousness, you slip into the groove thus created, you would find it more desirable to use the exalted consciousness and thus be in the world, but not of it. The same power which the Elohim wield to create a planet or a galaxy is within you. And I, Hercules, have come to prod you on as I stand by the side of our mighty El Morya, in whose being there is no lethargy. He is concentrating his mighty powers to clear your consciousness of limitation in an endeavor to quickly bring this planet to the perfection which she once knew. How much do you love the beloved El Morya? Now is your opportunity to prove that love. Anticipating your God action, I am Hercules. Oh, I just loved it. So marvelous. And Hercules, just wonderful. Bless him. Right. So now we're going to listen to the beloved Sinead O'Connor. And she's just a marvelous soul. I always had so much respect for her. She was truly brave and she spoke the truth. And a lot of people, she got into trouble for it, but she was a wonderful activist and a wonderful Irish woman. Anyway, bless her mighty heart. I know she'll be welcomed in the heavenly realms. And she'll be with those mighty ascended masters. Not for long, I'm sure. As I said, I think she's a true warrior of the light and a bringer of truth. God bless her brave soul forever. So we're going to listen to her singing when she was young. It's just beautiful, I thought. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. So beautiful.
Sinead, any chance?
Of a little song.
It's not a different kind of a song because you look so different.
No, I was going to do that, and then I decided I wouldn't.
No. All right, you're just going to do your own thing. Very good. Or anything at all, Sinead. That would be nice.
Make me a channel of your peace.
It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. It is in giving to all men that we receive, and in dying that we are born to eternal life.
Bless her heart. And she had quite a troubled life, and she's just a lovely, lovely soul. I really always had so much time for her. Bless her. All right, so beloved aunt isn't back on, so she said to me, please do it. So she can't hear. She's got her phone in rice, she says. Oh my gosh. All right, so we're going to say our decrees for the world, and we're just going to open our hearts, connect to our mighty I Am presence. As we know, Mighty Hercules reiterated it for us as the mighty power of our mighty I Am presence as we say the decrees. So we say together with our hearts open and a great desire for the perfection, the golden age for our beloved Saint Germain. Mighty I Am Presence, great host of ascended masters, archangels and Elohim, cosmic beings and great cosmic light, come forth now in all your cosmic power. Withdraw and withhold all power from destructive forces and individuals with destructive intent throughout the world right now and forever, whether it is conscious or unconscious. Expose, seize, bind, and render helpless all these sinister forces and their activities until the light has removed them completely, and illumine the source so this may never act again, and raise up to positions of power the divinely chosen leaders. Replace all with the ascended master consciousness and the divine plan fulfilled. And we thank you. And now we're going to do our very important decree for protection for ourselves, our loved ones, and all the constructive people on the earth and places and things. So we say together, beloved mighty I Am presence, beloved Archangel Michael, and beloved Commander Conrad, continually intensify your protective pillar of pure light substance and Archangel Michael's armor of light through and around me, charged with your invincible protection, all-powerful and impenetrable. I am invisible. I am invincible. I am invulnerable to anything but thy almighty perfection. And I am grateful we are given whatever added protection is needed. And what we ask for ourselves, we ask for our loved ones and that which is constructive in all mankind and the world. And we thank you. So let's just take time now to visualize as we make this call, so our I Am presence intensifies our tube of light. All those little inner workers, the little elementals standing shoulder to shoulder, constructing that thick wall of light around our earthly bodies. Wonderful. Armor of light fashioned from Archangel Michael's armor of light. Visualize it around ourselves, our loved ones, our homes, all the constructive people, places, conditions, and things across the earth. It's a wonderful opportunity, and we just give deep, deep thanks for this. Now we say, the decree for divine justice so greatly needed on our beloved earth. I am the most intensified cosmic action of the flame of divine justice blazing throughout the world right now and forever. I am the law. I am the justice. I am the judge. I am the jury. Knowing that I am all powerful, then I know that only divine justice can be done everywhere. Here and now. Beloved Lady Portia, ensure divine justice prevails throughout the world, right now and forever. And so be it, and so it is, and it is done. Beloved I Am, we thank you. And we thank beloved Lady Portia now for calling in that mighty goddess of liberty. We say, beloved cosmic I Am presence and great goddess of liberty, direct the cosmic light of liberty as of a thousand suns into the cause and core of anything attempting to delay the divine plan of the great white brotherhood for the earth's eternal freedom and release from all tyranny here and now. So be it, beloved I Am. And we thank you. In the name of my mighty I Am presence, great cosmic beings and great cosmic light, I decree, I am the presence charging the minds and feelings of everybody in America and the world with Saint Germain's ascended master consciousness and perfection right now and forever. I am the presence blessing, illumining, perfecting, and setting all free in service to the light. And now we've got our wonderful opportunity to call in that beloved violet fire. And as we know, the gift of the violet flame literally changes wrongly qualified substance and replaces it with the perfection, the immaculate concept for all life. So we say together, mighty I Am presence, beloved Saint Germain, and those that minister to the violet flame, come forth now and blaze your cosmic violet fire and cause a mighty victory for all the world to see. I am the law of forgiveness in cosmic action now. I am the victory of the sacred fire in all its cosmic power. Mighty angels descend with your purple wands of fire and strike them into the center of every place where there has been a history of sinister force activity. Transmute and consume it all. Cause, call, record, effect, and memory, and set it all free from that which was never meant to be. Replace it all with the ascended master consciousness and the divine plan fulfilled. And we thank you. Now we listen to the blue Danube, which holds within the melody the keynote of the violet fire. You can feel it. It's marvelous.
Thank you.
we just call in the mighty victory of the light and we say together, I am the victory of the light. I am the victory of the light. I am the victory of the light. I am the cosmic flame of victory which reigns supreme everywhere, right now and forever. We accept these calls answered as they are made according to thy will, with full cosmic power, maintained and doubled each instant of each hour until fully manifest. And so be it, and so it is, and it is done. Beloved I am, we thank you. And now we just finish off, as we always do, just calling in that wonderful light from the secret love star, that mighty focus of cosmic divine love held there, that called forming a mighty focus of divine love from the great central sun. As we know, that is supreme light. It can never be re-qualified by human thoughts or feelings. So let's just open our hearts, call to our mighty and presence and the great beloved beings ministering to the secret love star. And we call to the great spirit of the secret love star. And we ask now that these rays, these mighty cosmic rays, be directed into every human heart. And by the beloved grace and love of that threefold flame in each and every one, they get drawn in like a magnet, saturating the earthly bodies of every man, woman, and child evolving on this beloved earth, both in and out of embodiment, to be saturated with that feeling, that ascended master light substance of unconditional love. And we ask that it saturate our beloved elementals, each and every precious one, especially all those distorted, destructive, or distressed elemental life. And we know that around our planet, it's in great need of this unconditional love. Let's just feel the joy and the happiness as it floods into the human hearts of everybody. That wonderful feeling of pure divine love. We ask the angels from the great central sun to maintain and self-sustain this action till we are truly one holy family. Saint Germain's glorious vision of a utopia on our beloved earth made manifest. Let's just feel that wonderful feeling in our hearts. As we know, it gets directed as we make the call, and we just give deep, deep thanks for this and to all the great beings invoked. And now we're going to say the closing invocation. And Trish, would you like to read it?
Thank you, Anthea. I'd love to read it. Before ending the session, we all say with our mics muted, beloved I am presence and beloved Master Katumi, nourish the seeds planted in my consciousness so that the ideas entrusted to me become manifest flowers of perfect expression in my world and the world of all my fellow men. Beloved presence of God, I am. Pour the light of thy great glory upon my consciousness and nourish the seeds planted by the masters. We thank you.
Lovely. Thank you so much, beloved Trish. Okay, lovely. So let's just finish off with just a moment of opening our hearts and just filling them with that feeling of love and gratitude. Gratitude for these wonderful teachings. Gratitude to our beloved Ascended Master friends, and just gratitude to our I Am presence and all life that serves us and our loved ones. Thank you for everything in our world. Oh, thank you. And so there we have it for this week. Thank you so much, everybody. I'm going to stop the recording.